Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. My name is Nadira Binti Hanafia. My matric number 117-1474 and the title of my proposal is Development of Vegan Tofu Ice Cream and Determination of its Protein Content by Dye-Binding Method. Tofu desserts? It sounds dirty. Hold up, please watch first and hear to my explanations. Here are the outlines. For the introduction, so basically the heavy whipped cream that usually been used in regular vanilla ice cream is substituted with the equal amount with the combination of firm silken tofu and melted silk milk with the respected ratio 2 to 1. The problem statement, according to Julie and Manella, kids or children especially from the age of 2 on any given day, they are more prone to eat processed sweets rather than healthy foods. Some of the processed sweets and desserts are very high in sugar, unhealthy and unbeneficial. Second, the heavy whipped cream that are usually being used in ice cream making are very high in calories. Third, people with lactose intolerance and vegans are not able to consume foods or desserts that have dairy or even any animal-based ingredients. And fourth, our bodies need protein in relatively large amount to stay healthy. However, not all desserts are rich in proteins. So, the purpose is to solve the problems faced by lactose intolerance people, vegans, kids, and even anyone at any ages that are craving for sweet foods or desserts but trying to stay healthy. The objectives are, firstly, to develop a healthier version of ice cream that is high in protein content but low in calorie by formulating ice cream from firm silken tofu, and second, to analyze the protein content of this vegan tofu ice cream by using a dye-binding method or a Bedford assay. So I divided my literature review into four main parts. For the first part is I'm differentiating between the regular vanilla ice cream with heavy whipped cream and the vegan tofu ice cream, which is also in the vanilla flavor. For the regular vanilla ice cream with heavy whipped cream, the protein content is plus minus 1 gram for each 100 gram, whereas for the vegan tofu ice cream is plus minus 11.00 gram for each 100 gram, which is more higher than the regular vanilla ice cream. For the calorie value of for the regular vanilla ice cream is about plus minus 138 calories, whereas the vegan tofu is only plus minus 100 calories. For the regular vanilla ice cream, there are usually use sugar or condensed milk as their sweetener, while for the vegan tofu ice cream, we use maple syrup as a sweetener. For the second part of my literature review, I'm differentiating between the regular vanilla whipped cream and the tofu whipped cream. So basically, both whipped cream can whip beautifully, but the protein content concentration is different. Of course, for the whipping cream, we have plus minus 2.7 gram for each 100 gram. Meanwhile, for the tofu whipped cream, we have about plus minus 11 gram for each 100 gram, which is more higher than the regular heavy whipped cream. For the third literature review, is we talk about the science behind the combination of silken tofu and melted silk milk as a whipping cream substitute. So basically, the high protein content is what give the aeration property to the ice cream, and second, it helps to increase the height and reducing the density of the ice cream, and third, it helps to increase the overrun of ice cream. For the melted silk milk, it is used to remove clumps of the silken tofu so that a smoother texture of ice cream can be obtained. Why melted silk milk? It is because, firstly, melted silk milk is preferred over other milk is because it has a quite high percentage of protein, that is about 3.6%. And we also use it to minimal waste, to fully utilize a melon, and it is because it is rare and lack of research is being done. For the fourth part of my literature review is I'm comparing between the dye-binding method and gel dye method. Why dye-binding method is chosen over gel dye method in this vegan tofu ice cream protein determination is because dye-binding method does not overestimate the protein concentration. It is suitable in measuring food with a low to moderate protein content like frozen confection, and it also measures overall of the protein. And the last but not least, it is a very inexpensive, rapid, and status as an official AOSC procedure for determining protein in dairy products. For the materials, here are the ingredients that we need for vegan tofu ice creams and the instruments. So for the materials for die binding, here are the materials and the instrument used. For the vegan tofu ice cream formulation, the recipe is enough for a 250 ml container. For the preparation is basically we blend all the ingredients together, pour the mixture into an ice cream churning machine and the refrigerate overnight. For the methods in determining protein content of this vegan tofu ice cream is divided into 5 easy steps, which is prepare the standard solution, measure the absorbent of the standard solution, measure the absorbent of the unknown in the spectrophotometer, and last but not least, graph the unknown concentration of vegan tofu ice cream on the standard curve. So here are the example of the standard curve. So from here we can find the absorbance of the unknown, and then we can check the its concentration on the x-axis. Pardon me, the base concentration is supposed to be the regular vanilla ice cream concentration. So here are the proximity analysis that are adapted by the Guitar Bisla et al. 2012 and Fausen et al. 2019. Moisture, ash, fat, protein. We also do the physical chemical analysis on pH overall and calorie value. So here are my Gantt chart, and here are more references. Thank you.